Hi guys, in today's video, I will show you how to use the REW EQ Wizard or REW, a calibrated microphone like the Umik-1 and the Eversolo A8 to measure and improve the sound from your hi-fi system. We can go from this frequency response to this corrected frequency response using the built-in FIR filters in the A8. These are the hardware that are required. Firstly, a laptop computer, either a Windows or a Mac computer. Secondly, a calibrated microphone. I highly recommend the Umik-1 for mini DSP. Thirdly is the USB cable to connect from your microphone to the laptop. Do note whether it is a USB-C or USB-A connection. Number four is the Eversolo A8 Streamer DAC preamp. Number five is the USB cable to connect the Eversolo, which is a USB-B connection, to the laptop, either USB-A or USB-C. Number six is a thumb drive, and optional will be seven, a tripod. Firstly, we need to install the USB driver for the Eversolo. Go to the Eversolo website and click under support. Click under all. And if you scroll down, you can find the link that we want. Go to connect and use Eversolo streamers with a PC. Click on it. And there's a link here to download the driver. Install. Double click to open. Install the driver. Okay, it's done. Next, we need to download the mic calibration file. For this microphone, we go to Mini DSP website. Go under products, Umik-1. If you scroll below, there's a box for you to key in the serial number. And this serial number is located on the microphone itself or on the box of the microphone. Submit, and you can retrieve the calibrated file from the website. So there are two files here. One is a regular calibration file, where it's based on the microphone facing to the speakers, and a 90 degree calibration file where the microphone is facing 90 degrees, facing up. And this is actually used more for home theater applications. Do remember where you save this file, and this file is actually based on each microphone is slightly different, and they were calibrated in the factory, and the deviations are actually stored in this text file. Now we download the REW EQ Wizard software from www.rewEQWizard.com. It's a free software and available to be used for Windows, Mac, and Linux operating systems. Download and install into your computer. This is an optional step to download a house curve. Search online to download your preferred house curve onto your computer as a text file. I'll be using the Harman curve, and we can see it in use later. This is how we will be connecting the hardware. I'm assuming that you already have your Eversolo A8 already connected to your amplifier and hi-fi systems using the connections in red. We'll need to add the connections in blue, which are the connections from the microphone to the laptop and from the laptop to the Eversolo A8 using USB cables. Now we place the microphone to face towards the loudspeakers, and the tip of the microphone should be placed at the middle of the head location at the usual listening position. The Umik-1 comes with a small tripod in the box, and for this example, I'm using my own tripod, so it's easier. Connect the microphone to the laptop. Now we connect the Eversolo to the laptop. Behind the Eversolo A8, there's a USB-A and USB-B connection. Use only the USB-B connection here, and the other end is to be connected to your laptop. On the home screen, select source and click on USB-B input. Make sure the output port is exactly what you have now. Now we open the REW software, which we have already downloaded earlier. When you first open REW with the microphone plugged in, it will ask you if you have the calibration file. Please select the calibration file which was saved earlier. Use the standard and not the 90 degree file. Now click on Preferences. And first, we have to choose the output device and make sure that it is showing the Eversolo. For the input device, make sure we are selected for EXCL, microphone, Umik-1. And make sure that the output selection are selected on right side for now. We'll do the left side later. We can also check that the calibration files are loaded correctly under the second tab. We will now check the levels to make sure that we have sufficient volume for the calibration to be done. We can adjust the volume from the Eversolo A8 or the amplifier or from the computer. Make sure that we have an output of around minus 30 to minus 50 decibels. Now we will proceed to take measurement of our right speaker. Let's key in first the name of the file that we are doing today. And this is to set a delay, so we can have a few seconds to get out of the way before the measurement starts. And this is to select between single measurement and multiple measurements. And make sure that the right output is selected. Press start to commence the countdown and frequency sweep. We now have the measurement result for the right speaker. First, we apply a smoothing, which is I've selected the 1/6 smoothing, and this is more representative of what we understand about frequency response. So you can see different dips and troughs, and the black line is actually the microphone calibration line. Now we click on EQ to start working on this file. Under EQ, select generic as the model, and for target settings, my speaker is a full range speaker, but there are options for bass limited speaker. You can see the roll off here, and you can adjust the frequency cutoff and as well as the slope. This is what we want our speaker to be close to at the end. And we can also adjust for full range speaker and the slope. So that's commonly selected is 12 and 24 decibels per octave. I've uploaded the house curve, which I've saved earlier. If you don't want to have a house curve, you can have a flat curve, which some people prefer, but I prefer either a house curve or the built-in curve that we have. So I've uploaded the house curve here, and you can see the increase in SPL for the bass and then a slight gentle slope on the high end. You can also select the built-in curve. Click Add Room Curve here, and you can adjust the parameters to adjust the line in blue. But do note, if you select House Curve, you got to unselect the additional room curve, else you'll be adding on both of these curves together. For this exercise, we'll use the House Curve that I've uploaded. And the target level here is preset. So what we can do is we can have the system to calculate the target level from the response. Click here. So you will try to adjust a target level which is somewhere in between the measured curve that we had. Now we go to filter task. For the adjustment range, I put it between 20 and 20 kHz. For the individual max boost, I've left it at 6 decibels and the overall minimum boost at 0 decibels. For the flatness range, I put it at 2 decibels for now, but you can always adjust to 1. I suggest to keep both the adjust narrow filters above 200 Hz and vary max Q above 200 Hz. Click on match response to target. The system will now calculate the filters to be used to try to match the frequency response to the target settings. You can now see the measured figure for the frequency response as well as the predicted frequency response. If you're happy with this, now go to File, Export, select Export Filter Impulse Response as a WAV. Make sure that it's selected at 48 kHz. Save the file and we'll need to retrieve it later. Now that we have completed for the right side speaker, we need to do for the left speaker. Go to preferences and then select the output speaker as left and the input as left. There's no need to do the level matching again, so we straight away head to measure. Make sure the speaker output is left and click start. We now have the measured response for the left speaker. Same thing, let's do the smoothing from the graph. And click on EQ. Select the same parameters as before. Let's adjust the target level to be same as what we had before, rather than trying to calculate from the response. The rest of the filter tasks should be the same. And then click on match response to target. Now that we have completed the adjustment for the left side, we can export the filter file, same as what we have done for the right side. Both the right and the left frequency response are now available at the same screen. You can also overlay them to see both of them together as well as the averages. Is the predicted levels after the correction. And you can play with the different settings, which we will not be discussing today. You can save the measurements under File, Save All Measurements, so you can go back to this file for future adjustments. Now copy the filter files that we have saved for the left and right channels and put it in a thumb drive and plug it into the back of the Eversolo here. If you have enjoyed my content, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. From the home screen, select DSP, press the big press button, and you can name your file, and I've called this file as Full Range. From this configuration, we can add the filters that we just downloaded into the thumb drive. So for the left channel, click on import, go to where the file was saved under filters. For me, it'll be left side. So you can see the filter has been uploaded. And now we do the same for the right side. And you see both of them are already in the Eversolo. You need to click the two tabs here to make sure they are being used. Okay, now they're already inside. We got to configure the input. So in the Eversolo, you can actually configure different DSP for different inputs. So I'm configuring now internal player to be able to use the full range filters. So you can tap between no filter and full range filters here. You can adjust from the front panel under DSP or from the app, which I'll show later. And you can set different DSP options for different inputs. Don't forget to select your source, which was previously set as USB in and now put back to internal player. Congratulations, you have now managed to measure your Hi-Fi system, perform corrections in REW and install the filters into your Eversolo A8. I'll show you how you can select the filter in the Eversolo app. In this app, please select on the DSP when you play the song and you can select between no filters and full range, which we had set before. And there's also a toggle on off whether we want to have DSP or not. Do note that if you on DSP, the volume will be reduced by 5 decibels. You can also configure the DSP settings for the various inputs using the Eversolo app. Hope you have found the video useful. I will have another video in the future where I will share more things that we can do to improve the measurements and various adjustments in REW.